So right now, of course, we know that the only three sexualities that count are national, anti-national, and soldier. Right? And our sexuality, in order to actually think about what are the challenges for that 377, or actually, which is actually a euphemism for a queer movement, to actually think about, right? And so you have to think that when the nation state actually emerges, this lovely country that we call India, it emerges on two counts. One is the partition, where you have mass rapes and abduction of women, and a whole apparatus comes into play of recovering Indian women from Pakistan and Pakistani women from India. But lest you might think that they're recovering all women, they actually go on to only recover young, fertile women. Right? Because the project in the nation, so old women, they go to hell, and they don't matter, menopausal women don't matter, and only young women are actually got recreated from abducted Muslims or abducted Hindus, and an actual exchange happens between the nation. That creates the citizen as sex. Right, so the person who gets to come back to the nation is already famed in citizenship. Nayanika Mukherjee actually reveals the process on the other side. You know, we also did part only around the northern western frontier. We also parted on the eastern side. And Nayanika reveals a mechanism that the men might actually enjoy. So in order to recommend who to bring back the males, to bring back, because Bangladesh is really small, can't lose out on its population, etc. So the state actually deploys various kinds of forces to bring back Muslim men and Muslim women to Bangladesh. Huh? Because at that time, East Pakistan, a country that no longer exists, right? It suddenly go out from that. So in East Pakistan, so what happens is soldiers, our lovely soldiers, are actually interested in not only bringing back Muslim women, but are checking men's lungis and dhotis whether or not they're circumcised. Right? And if you're not circumcised, then what happens to you is completely, nobody knows, there's no law of that, and if you are, then you are brought back into territory, right? So, certain kind of sexual policing is central to the way in which the nation state is made, right? Unfortunately, only some bodies tend to be sexually policed and not others. For example, the sex worker we go to hell from times of yore, right? And it is precisely in conjunction with the sex worker that you have the emergence of the respectable Indian woman, Bharat Mata, right? Not every woman gets to be Bharat Mata. Not every woman gets to be revered, much like not all goddesses become goddess incarnate. So the sex worker actually, sexuality is both used as a pin for discipline and that which marks an excess. Right? That which marks an excess both in terms of a laboring body like a sex worker but also the feudal aristocrat which needs to be checked. Right? So think about Lihav. Right? Where the feudal hangover actually is central to the Nawabi habit. Or that which needs to be disciplined into modernity. And it's not simply the Hindu right that actually does this kind of disciplining around people's bodies, but actually very well the nation constitutional state, right? Which wants to discipline you and bring you into the modern. Now, one of the ways in which coming into the modern happened is very well tied to something that the petition also does, and that is why we are, because Shashi Tharoor is actually referred to the concept that I must bring this up. This going to the Shastras as evidence of existence of people is actually deeply tied to this history of the going back to the Shastras that you have in the petition as well, and in Tharoor. Tharoor's whole speech is like, but 2000 saal se, but you know, this Shastra and that Shastra, and I'm very happy that he's well versed in all of this. But this is intimately tied to the way in which sexuality has been framed for you by the nation state. Right? So now you're going to be like, oh, I don't care about the nation state. Not so easy. Right? The queer subject actually is deeply